A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have pity on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he kept calling out all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take courage, get up. Jesus is calling you." He threw aside his cloak, sprang up, and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him in reply, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man replied to him, "Master, I want to see." Jesus told him, "Go your way. Your faith has saved you." Immediately he received his sight and followed him on the way. Sisters and brothers in Christ, mga kabahagi, the good news of our salvation. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, ito po ang ating ebanghelyo para sa araw na ito. Medyo maikli lang po ang ating ebanghelyo. Ayusin ka lang muna po ang aking screen. Saan na po yun? Okay. Jesus was leaving Jericho. Jericho po, ito ay isang sikat na kwento sa Old Testament. Kung nalala po natin, di ba yung walls of Jericho, mga pader ng Jericho na kung saan God told the Israelites to go inside Jericho. And to be able to go inside, they had to go around the walls of Jericho for 7 days. And on the 7th day, 7 beses lang iikot. Tapos sila ay magpupuri sa ating Panginoon Diyos. Then the walls of Jericho fell down. Doon duman si Jesus. So most probably, it had meaning for the Israelites and for Jesus and the disciples when they were passing Jericho. So ano po yung scenario? Galing po sa Capernaum or Galilee, they were going to Jerusalem. And going to Jerusalem, they had to pass by the town of Jericho. And, you know, they were also followed by a large crowd, not only by the 12 disciples. On his way to Jerusalem, there was a blind beggar called Bartimaeus. And according to some scholars, probably they were on their way to Jerusalem for the Passover. Magpa-Passover kasi pupunta si Jesus sa Jerusalem at ipapako na siya sa krus noon. Papako na sa krus. And this event took place, according to the scholars, a week before the death of Jesus. So isang linggo bago ipapako si Jesus sa krus. So in the Gospel of St. Mark, it is actually the last miracle to be recorded in that gospel, yung bulag na nakakita. And it is also unusual for the gospel writers, traditionally speaking, for the gospel writers to name the people that were healed. But here we can see that the name of the blind man was revealed. Pati nga tatay niya, di ba, Timaeus, so son of Timaeus. At ang pangalan ng blind man is Bartimaeus. And in the Greek translation, the word or the name Bartimaeus means honorable son sa Greek translation po. Bakit po honorable son, no? Anak na may honor or honorable son. Malalaman po natin mamaya. So here is the scenario. Jesus was passing by and there were many beggars and people along the road. At nalaman ng blind man that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by, kaya he was shouting at the top of his voice. Sabi niya, "Jesus, son of David." Bakit kaya may title na son of David? Because it indicates that Jesus was of a royal origin and a true-blooded Israelite. Royal line, kumbaga binibigyan ng blind man ng title si Jesus, parang papuri na rin yun. Pagkikilala or pagpapakilala or kinikilala niya na si Jesus ay galing sa isang lineage na puro mga hari. Kaya nga, di ba sa ating faith, he is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Kaya kumbaga may authority, may kapangyarihan nung tinawag niyang Son of David. And blind people during that time, people who were sick, crippled, may ketong, they were considered outcast. Kumbaga, hindi ka pwede makahalubilo sa mga malulusog. with the regular crowd. They were considered outcasts. Kaya nung he was shouting, "Jesus, Son of David," anong ginawa? The crowd rebuked him. Parang not only discrimination, but more of parang wala kang karapatan na lumapit sa kanya. No? You are an outcast, you are a sinner, kaya ka bulag dahil makasalanan ka. Pero nung rinirebuke siya, ano nangyari? All the more he shouted, ayaw niyang tumigil. And this shows us that whenever we approach God and ask for certain prayer requests, huwag tayong magsasawa humingi sa Diyos. Ask, and ask. Humingi tayo sa ating Panginoon Diyos. Never get weary, never give up. Because the blind man, in spite of his crippled, in spite of his being blind, he never gave up asking Jesus, even though the crowds were rebuking him, they were telling him not to do so. Kaya kuminsan, di ba sa prayers natin, parang feeling natin, huwag ka nang pagdasal, huwag ka nang humingi, no, yung tukso na ganyan. Maybe the crowds of the evil spirit is trying to hinder us from exercising our faith in God, exercising our faith in Jesus. But here, the blind man gave us an example never to give up asking God. Why? Because Jesus, the Son of David, will have pity on him, maaawa sa kanya, na magkakaroon ng compassion. And this is what actually God is. Who God is? God, our God, our loving Father, has pity on those who calls upon Him. Yes, naaawa ang Diyos. Minsan kasi ang tingin natin sa Diyos parang tyrant, parang tagaparusa, parang kumbaga, parang laging galit. No, God is a loving Father, and all we have to do is to never give up in asking petitions from God. That's why here the blind man shouted all the more. Lagi siyang sumisigaw, "Jesus, Son of David." Kaya Bartimaeus exercised his faith. And you know, there are three stages of faith. Pataas ng pataas yung stage na yan. Unang-unang stage is believing faith. And many of us believe that there is a God. Kaya lang, kung belief lang, parang walang pagkakaiba si demonyo. Bakit po? In the letter of James, no, nakalagay po doon, "Do you believe in God? Good. Even the demons or the demons believe and shudder with fear." No? So, naniniwala tayo, kaya lang ugali ng isang tao, ang karakter ng isang tao parang pinapakita na wala siyang kinikilala or pinaniniwalaan na Diyos. So, dapat mas mataas na level. At ano yun?